talk a little bit about the power of getting all the allergens out of the system, and with those we keep irritating the gut lining, such as gluten and that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I know, like, for example, I decided I've had some pretty major stress in my life the last few months, and very major. And I decided to try a little bit of gluten, and I instantly felt my immune system lower. I got cold sores. So just at how, when you get things out of your system, how much more your body will react to it. And sugar, a lot of grains, gluten being some of them, and how those continue. You can put all the probiotics or all the stuff in the world into your system, but if you're doing the offending foods, then you'll have a really hard time healing. So what's your experience on that?
Yeah, I absolutely agree with that. And I mean, the case for grains and sugars and carbohydrates is that all carbohydrates break down into sugars. So what do bacteria eat? They eat sugars. So again, if you have a predominance of unhealthy bacteria in your gut and you're eating grains and carbs, you're feeding those microbes. So your good bacteria can't get a handhold in there because you're daily strengthening the pathogenic bacteria and yeast, because yeast is another. And then now we have bacterial fungal hybrids, like the mycobacterium. Well, they eat sugar too. So, I mean, sugar, think about it, trees. What do trees eat? Trees eat sugar. They grow to 200 feet tall on sugar. Sugar is a very potent food source, and pretty much all organisms eat and thrive on sugar. So it's not that sugar is this evil substance. I think we need to get rid of that. I think we need to get out of the thing of saying sugar is bad. Sugar is a foundation of life. Breast milk, I don't know, because I've had three kids, I've drunk my own breast milk. Breast milk is super sweet. And I've drunk my dog's milk, and I've drunk my cat. You know, like any milk you drink when I was a kid, I milked my dogs. I was like, I wonder what that tastes like. They're all really sweet. They're all really high in sugars, because that's what sustains life and creates maximum growth. So that's the other thing we have to keep in mind, that it's just about what's in your gut already, because that's what you're feeding. So if you want to keep that candida and all those pathogens alive and robust, stay on your grains, stay on your sugar. But if you want to, we're talking like if you've got MAP, you're looking at a 2 to 3 year process to get rid of those, because they have a dormant active life cycle. So my wild oregano oil protocol, which combines wild oregano all day and then high dose Natron probiotics at night, you have to cycle off and on that for 2 years, but then you'll feel better. You'll feel better the whole time as you go along. And then you'll feel better because you'll have killed everything that's active, and you'll be like, I feel amazing. And then maybe a few weeks, or you're like, oh, I'm starting to feel crap again. You go, this didn't work. No, it's because the next batch is coming active again. They're coming to life. So you go back on the protocol and you kill that batch. You feel amazing. And then you cycle. You cycle like this for 2 to 3 years. That's how long it takes. But meanwhile, and in the in-between phases when you feel good, you're hitting the probiotics really hard because, you know, you've killed off a big population that was preventing those. So you want to get those. And maybe you're doing the probiotic retention enema during that time period. So the sugars are, you know, if you... And I mean, there's actually clinical studies on how grains affect people with colitis. I've got some of them, I quote some of them in my book. So the ideal thing that I tell people is, and with gluten, like when you said you tried gluten, did you mean you had wheat?
Yes.
Yeah. So we have the wheat in North America has been so mutated that's why most people are like, oh, I'm gluten intolerant. No. It's our North American wheat. I have naturopaths that I do tell seminars with, and like this one woman, she has an entire clientele she specializes in hormone balance. She has hundreds of women who can't eat wheat in North America. And whenever they go over to France or Italy, where they have protected their heritage wheat strains, and they don't use pesticides, and they don't use, like the grain is what people ate hundreds of years ago, they can eat bread and pasta with no problem. So that's another thing. We have to look at how agribusiness has changed those fundamental grains that we are consuming. So we're not looking at, oh, well, this is a natural grain. Humans have eaten wheat for thousands of years. Yeah, not the wheat we're eating, though. So that's another thing to take into consideration. So for people with IBD and IBS, absolutely, get off the grains, all grains, for a period of time, and then go low grain and stick to things like quinoa and millet. And, you know, although, see, then we're back into the balancing. Because if you have someone who's already malnourished and can maybe tolerate 10 foods, and you tell them stop eating rice, well, they're probably going to lose weight. Because they need to, rice is the kind of the thing that's keeping them going, because it's, so there you're back into that balancing, right? And the elemental diet product we talked about, it has a carbohydrate component. It has tapioca maltodextrin, which is a glucose polymer. Without it, you will not gain weight. You will receive your protein and your amino acids and all your, but you will stay malnourished. You will stay 99 pounds. Maybe you'll get up to 100, 101. But for you to get to up to that healthy weight, you have to give the body that carbohydrate for that period of time. So guess what's going to happen while you're on that? Your candida is going to go up too, because your candida is like, yoo-hoo, we love maltodextrin. So again, you're back into the balancing of the healing in layers. You can't heal every, these diseases are multi-systemic, they're multi-layered. You can't heal it, boom, all at once. So you got to go for the big stuff first. If you're hemorrhaging and you're malnourished, that's more important than candida. So you go, let's clear those. But the other thing we realized after, again, thousands of people testing, when you go on the elemental diet, from day one, you start the wild oregano oil protocol. So you are helping your body and you're keeping that candida from going hog wild. So you stay on it the whole time you're on the diet. And we realize now that, yes, wild oregano is safe for people in extreme disease states and all the rest of it. And then when you finish the elemental diet, you stay on it. And then you're probably on it for 2 years to kill that cycle of mycobacteria that we talked about. So you're kind of coming at it from several layers simultaneously. So again, someone who's severely malnourished may not be able to get off all the grains and carbs. And then someone who, let's say you are at a decent weight, you can get rid of all the grains and carbs for a period. And then you probably want to start, you know, having some potatoes and some yams. And so have your starches, but have them in vegetable form would be better than going to grains. So that kind of build it. Because if you go without, and I've done this, I've gone without any for up to a year at a time. And it's interesting what happens with the body. Like I have the most vitality and I need the least amount of sleep, but my body gets really lean and sinewy, like an Arctic wolf, right? Like in the winter, not in the spring. I start feeling I need some carbs. So then we're into, you know, there's a balance there. And then you need to, yeah, you need to find that, and you need to find the forms of carbohydrates that your body likes the most. And again, then we're into the mind-body interplay. Like you're going through a really stressful time. Maybe you need some chocolate, right? And maybe you need some, like I make my own chocolate and it's sweetened with stevia and a little bit of xylitol because I can tolerate xylitol. A lot of people can't. And, you know, some chopped up dried fruit. But there's times where you're like, I need some sugar because this is like super stressful and I hate my life. And me having, you know, a few pieces of real chocolate is going to change my evening and I'm going to go to bed feeling happy and positive. Well, how much healing is that giving you? So there's always that dialing into your heart, dialing into your gut, looking for the balance, what's right at this time.
You're talking to a big foodie. We're just putting together a food book. Then I teach food classes and how to eat super healthy. And when you're talking about carbohydrates and also those monosaccharide carbohydrates, such as squash, I found much easier on my gut than potatoes. The monosaccharides, when the mucosal lining and the villi are flattened with inflammation. So yeah, finding the perfect ones at the time, and then maybe after you can add that little bit of yam. Mm-hmm.